tabletop case removal. To begin, remove four keys from the keyboard. The F1 and F2 buttons. If you wish, you can remove the scissor mechanism with a flathead screwdriver. After the scissor mechanism is removed, you'll notice one Phillips head screw in the keyboard. Remove this. And now the last two keys, the F11 and F12 keys. Now close the laptop and flip it over. And remove the RAM bay door, which is held together with four Phillips head screws. Once the screws are removed, remove the RAM bay door, and you will notice a black Phillips head screw inside the RAM bay door. Remove this. Once the screw is removed, flip the laptop back over. And remove the keyboard, lift up and out, and flip over, and there you will notice a ribbon connector. Remove this from the logic board. Once the keyboard is put away, grab your Phillips head screwdriver and remove the Phillips head screws from the keyboard bay. Once the screws are removed from the keyboard bay, now remove two screws on either side of the PowerBook. Now remove the two top Phillips head screws from the back of the PowerBook. Now remove the battery, take your flathead screwdriver, and now lift up and out. There you will notice three Phillips head screws in the battery bay. Remove these as well. Once that is complete, flip the laptop over, and there you will also notice two Torx T6 screws in the very top of the top case. Once the screw is removed, you can loosen the top case from the very front. Now it's time to remove the cabling, the trackpad connector, the sound connector, and the power button connector. Now remove the top case by grabbing the top two ends and lifting up and work your way to the bottom. Now lift up and out to remove.